with WordPress, how we can use Jamstack with WordPress. So before getting started, can we have a quick poll, like how many of you here is hearing this word Jamstack for the first time? Can you raise your hands ki aapne Jamstack ye word pehli baar suna hai yahan pe? Iske pehle suna hai sabne? Okay. How many of you here have heard about Jamstack but don't know what exactly it means? Anyone? Okay. So I'm assuming most of the people here have heard about Jamstack but don't know what exactly it means, right? So by end of the session, hopefully we will be able to fix that problem. Okay? So let me get started. A quick introduction about me. I'm Harshal Limay. I'm working as a senior lead engineer for a company called FIS Global. I have around 10 years of experience, out of which first around 3 years I have worked exclusively with WordPress, and that was like the pre-Gutenberg era where we were using like the classic editor, and now I'm working with JavaScript from last 6 years exclusively with JavaScript. Most of the time I spend with AngularJS or ReactJS. Okay. Apart from that, I am a BuddyPress contributor. I have been a speaker at WordCamp Nashik in 2016, as well as I am an organizer for WordCamp Nagpur in 2017. And hopefully by the end of this session, we will have sufficient time for Q&A. If not, you can always reach out to me at my Twitter handle. Okay? Assuming I will have an account by the end of this session, looking at the current situation at Twitter. All right, so let's get started with the agenda. I am really not sure why, लेकिन जब मैं ये पूरा presentation बना रहा था, तो ये जो dialogue है ना, ये मेरे दिमाग में बहुत बार आ रहा था. मेरे पास एक scheme है. Anyone have heard about this dialogue before? कौन सी movie का है, किसी को बताइए? Exactly, 21 दिन में. लेकिन यहाँ पे नहीं होने वाला है. Here we are going to just talk about Jamstack and go home. Okay? All right, so agenda is quite simple. What is Jamstack? Why we should use Jamstack? And again, at the end, we will have a very short demo of Jamstack. Okay? So let's begin with what is Jamstack. Okay? But before answering this question, what is Jamstack? Have you ever noticed that from last one decade, we have been flooding with the all kinds of fancy term that ends with stack, right? We have mon stack, main stack, right? See, these are like, these many terms are out there. We have like lamb stack, mean stack, dam stack. We have a crab stack. This is not something I made up. This is a real thing. Apparently, crab stack stands for Keystone, React, and Apollo. So, yeah, this is very interesting choice of words, but okay. So, we had like so many stacks out there. Why did we need another, some kind of catchy term that ends with stack, right? Why did we need another term? So to answer this question, let's first look how our web request, right, our typical HTTP request used to work, right, in a traditional web-based application. Again, this is an oversimplification of whole process. There might be some kind of load balancers involved there, or there might be some kind of CDN lurking over there. But all in all, a web request looks something like this, right? There might be some guy here. So let's say this guy, Akur. And he's searching for some URL, right? He hits the URL tech.com/Arnold Chikrapurkar. Now, I know his last name is not Chikrapurkar, but if with my Varadi accent, if I try to pronounce that, it will take way more than 30 minutes. So let's stick with Chikrapurkar. Okay, so he hits that request goes to Apache. Apache, everyone know what is Apache? Yeah, Apache is our web server, okay? That request goes to Apache. Apache forwards that request to our CMS, which will be in our case WordPress. Okay. Now what WordPress will do is WordPress will forward that request to database. Again, MariaDB or MySQL. What it will do is, yeah, there is some guy, random guy in Nagpur who is looking for Arnold Chikrapurkar. Do you have some data on it? Database will return the data. Now what WordPress will do is WordPress will render that data. It will pack it with all kind of HTML and everything. It will forward that data to Apache, and Apache will simply load that, again give it back to the user, which will be rendered on his web browser, right? Now after an hour, again some other random guy do the same request, right? Visit the same URL from Pune. Some another guy visits that same URL. What will happen? Again same process, right? Apache web server, then CMS, then database, again rendering, and again going back to our web browser. Let's say 100 different guys in a last 24 hours visits the same page. What will happen? Exactly the same process, rendering the page, throwing it back to the web server, and web server again will throw it back to browser, right? Anyone notice any problem here? Anyone? Again, if your answer is why so many people are searching for Arnold Shikrapurkar, then that's not the problem. Okay, that's not the problem. The problem is here we are rendering exactly the same thing over and over again, right? We have the exact same data, exact same HTML layout. Still, we are doing the process of rendering it every time someone hits that page. If 100% hit that request, again we are rendering 1000%, still we are doing the same thing, right? And this is where the Jamstack comes into the picture, okay? So basically, Jamstack stands for, the Jam word in the Jamstack stands for JavaScript, APIs, and markup. It's not a specific technology or it's not a specific framework. It's a basically an architecture or a concept, we can say, that help us to create faster websites, which are scalable and more maintainable, okay? What Jamstack suggests us to do is, let's say what we did was we are rendering the same page over and over and again, right? So what Jamstack suggests us to do is, instead of rendering the page every time at the build time, what you can do is you can create static markup files, okay? Static markup files, and then when user requests for that specific page, right? Instead of rendering it at the runtime, you can simply present that file back to the user, okay? And again, if we deliver only the markup files, right, that website will look like something that was created in the 90s, right? It will be like very static. It will be like you will not have anything around it. There will be like bunch of text and user can only click on it, right? So just to make the website dynamic, what Jamstack suggests us to do is make the static dynamic or make the site more interactive with JavaScript. Right? JavaScript is something which you can use, and when I say JavaScript, it doesn't mean necessarily means I am talking about the vanilla JavaScript like document.query or document.addEventListener. You can use any kind of JavaScript framework out there like React, Angular, or Vue.js, or you can use meta frameworks, right? Like Nuxt, Next.js, or Gatsby. And at the end, if you want to communicate with your database, since it's a website, there will be always need to communicate with something, right? Database or some kind of third-party service. Then in that case, APIs comes into the picture. Let's say you created a e-commerce website. Since it is a Jamstack site, it will be static. But now you need to have a payment gateway there, right? So you will be integrating that payment gateway with APIs along with JavaScript, right? And there might be some kind of like search engine there, right? Algolia. So in that case also, you can use APIs along with JavaScript to integrate these kind of services in your Jamstack website. So by the words Jamstack, you have noticed like this is a very plain, what you can say, a very basic technologies which we already had. This is not something which invented right now. And again, this is not a specific framework or technology. This is just a concept or architecture which we used to follow to create the websites. So after converting our website, right? After converting our dynamic website, our website to Jamstack, what will happen is, first our request used to look something like this, right? Apache, then database communication, then sending the response. At the end, what will happen is, instead of like hitting the database, what will happen is user requests the data website web page. It will be simply presented from the server. Since our pages will be pre-rendered, there will be no need for database connectivity. It will be simply given back to user. And in case there is a CDN involved there, it can be simply returned from the CDN itself. So the whole concept is your website can be hosted via CDN itself. Okay. So now, there are like lots of tools out there which allow us to create Jamstack websites, right? Like there is Gatsby, Next.js, Astro. Anyone heard about these frameworks? Yes. So Next.js, then, and if these tools are not enough for you, then there is a website called jamstack.org, where the, on the site generators page, we will have 300 plus tools which allow you to create Jamstack websites. So that's pretty much it on how what is Jamstack. Let's take a quick look look at a quick demo where we will figure out what Jamstack actually is. What I'm doing is I'm creating a website. I have created a website using Next.js. But Next.js, again, I'll clarify that Next.js is not the only tool out there. It's a tool of my preference. But that now, am I audible? Font size. Oh, my bad. Good enough? Okay. So Next.js is something I prefer to use, but that is not the only tool out there. You can use Next.js or even SvelteKit to create sites like these. Okay. So what right now I have done here is, let's say I boot my dev server. So what I have done here is I am using WordPress to store all of my data, and this Next.js will fetch that data. Okay. Let's take a quick look at what our WordPress website looks like. So here is my basic WordPress setup. There are only two tools involved here. One is WordPress importer. Again, importer is not necessary. I have only used it to import the sample data, sample WordPress data files, right? And another tool is WP GraphQL. Anyone heard about GraphQL? It's a query language, right? It is a query language created by Meta. So again, GraphQL is not compulsory. You can even use REST APIs. That depends on what kind of tooling basically you are using. Since Next.js supports the GraphQL, I am using the WP GraphQL plugin. So now my server is boot up here. Next, I can simply go to my website. So now instead of like serving the HTML here in our WordPress blog, I can simply serve the HTML using my Next.js website. So now you will see that the loading is a little bit slow. The reason being, this is on the development mode. But when we compile this website and we put it on a server, it becomes way more faster. In order to compile this website, right now Next.js supports two commands. There is something called npm run build. And these commands are specific to Next.js. That necessarily doesn't mean it will work with every framework. So every framework will come along with their own commands. So what npm run build will do is, since we talked that everything will be compiled down and it will be generating the static markup files, right? So this is the process which it is doing. It will compile everything and it will generate markup pages for every post you have in your WordPress website. So let this process go on. Meanwhile, I have already created a build for the sake of this demo. So what I will do is, we can simply upload that build. Okay, I have already a site deployed and it doesn't allow me to deploy more than one website. So what I'll simply do is I'll delete this one. This is a Netlify server. So I am using Netlify for hosting, but you can use any server provider you want. So what I'll do is I'll simply drag my build and upload it to the server. Meanwhile, this is uploading. Okay, this is compiled. You can see there is a huge amount of code that is being generated. All these what this code has generated is these are the static files which will be served over the Netlify server. Meanwhile, this is uploading. Any questions or queries you have? Those are static pages. So when in the demo means here, right? These are static markup files basically generated by Next.js. These are static markups, not layouts. Yeah. Exactly. That depends on what exactly your requirements are, right? So I'll get back to this question. So now I have deployed my site on Netlify. I can simply go to this website, open it, and this will start working. And if I click something, it will instantly load. Since first download, it will download the page, the whole page, and then the client-side browser takes over, and client-side browser takes care of the routing process. Okay. Benefits, since we have statically rendered everything, the performance will be way better. Then developer experience,
the developer experience will be better since we will be decoupling everything, right? We will have a separate backend, we will have a separate frontend. In that case, our developer experience can be increased. Again, increased security, since we will be rendering static pages, the vector of attack, right? The areas which a hacker can leverage will be reduced. It will not, I'm not saying it will be 100% secure, but the attack vector itself reduces when you are using a static website. Again, greater scalability. Greater scalability means since you will be serving anything, everything on you can be serving everything on a CDN, it will be very easy for you to handle a large amount of traffic. And better maintainability, since the whole architecture will be decoupled, right? Your website will be hosted somewhere else, your backend will be hosted somewhere else. So in case you need to make some changes in your backend, it will not actually bring down your whole website, or you don't need to put your website in the maintenance mode. Again, it will be very easier for you to swap your infrastructure. For example, let's say in the backend you are using something like another CMS, and now you want to move to WordPress, right? So in that case, you don't need to actually create a theme itself. You just need to move your data from that CMS to WordPress and integrate your WordPress website with the your Jamstack framework. So that's pretty much it. Any other questions? Yeah, please.
How Jamstack is different from Cloudflare, or it's just an alternative to Cloudflare?
Cloudflare?
Yes.
See, Cloudflare is, as far as I know, I have never used Cloudflare, but it's a CDN, right? It's a CDN thing. This is a architecture. Sorry? Okay, I haven't heard about.
Yes.
Cloudflare, where you can host static pages, right? This can create static pages. So I'm assuming this is something you can host there. Yes. Yes. You can host something there. This is something you create to host, right? And even the best part about this website is you can host, literally host this thing anywhere, including GitHub pages, where you can host your whole website for free, since there will be no client-side logic involved. Most of the client-side logic will be from JavaScript. This can be literally hosted from a GitHub pages for free. You just need to map your domain, or even from a S3 bucket, right? So that is the whole advantages of Jamstack. Yes.
WordPress have a great plugins ecosystem, right? How many plugins right now?